Hey YouTube, Donald here from Music in the Making. So this weekend was an interesting one. It was Mother's Day and we did a pre-recording for doing like a virtual choir sort of video for the song The Blessing. With Mother's Day, we were able to still do our live stream service, each of the three services, and then at each campus, they had it set up where people could drive through and pick up a free coffee and a free cupcake for their moms and their family, which is pretty cool. And then for The Blessing, we came in on Wednesday before and recorded us playing it on stage. And then they had us wear the same clothing Wednesday and Sunday so that when they cut the video together with the recordings of the singers, it would look like the band was live on stage and we were like live streaming or something. So check it out.
Hi, Jaden.
Getting some more vlogs, baby.
Jaden's being silly. So they're talking through the, like, where they're gonna have the camera shots and stuff right now.
All the way up.
Train and tame dinosaurs and then there's dragons.
Yeah, just kind of warming up the muscles a little bit.
Do I need to clap again?
Is this your thing though?
May your presence come before you. Yeah.
I figured it out like halfway through and then I switched and we were in unison, but I was like doing something.
Yeah, I switched that right when we go to the bridge three, when it hits in your
when she pops the octave.
Well the one after she pops the octave. So when we switch, when she starts singing about presents, which is the third time, then we, okay, cool, hit it. Bridge two, yeah. Which is bridge two.
I just know about you, like, he's with you in the morning. That's how I heard.
Yep. Yeah, there's three bridges in here, right?
It's kind of nice that going to the 57th Street campus because it's actually a lot closer to my place than Sertoma was. It only takes me like 2 minutes to get to church. I'm not late or anything, but if I was, I wouldn't be that late. So they said we have to park in the back. I've never been in the back, so see where they want us to park here. I think I recognize.
I didn't know.
We got a little glass bottles of Coke here. We just want to show how much we appreciate you. Go get a cupcake. It's on us.
Gene, I think we have a question for all of you this morning.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, ladies, is this a succulent? Or is this...
This is a really interesting plant.
Do you water these?
Absolutely. It's pretty beautiful. We're actually giving every mother one of those today. Just to show how much we love and appreciate them.
Looks dead.
A succulent, yeah. And actually, they grow cupcakes.
This one.
It's a cupcake tree?
Actually, this one's a cupcake tree. Yeah, so after a while, if you keep watering it, it grows a cupcake. That's what we're giving away at all our campuses today.
That's where they got them. Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be a good morning. I'm excited.
Does the cupcake grow down here then?
Yeah, it is. You just actually pick it. You pick the whole plant
and then it just pops
pull
off.
It out of the ground and it's like the cupcake underneath it. And then you have to
Is the top the good part where the frosting goes?
Yeah.
Is that on the very bottom?
That's on the very bottom. It grows upside down. See, you pull it out. It's like the cupcake's right here with the frosting.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
It's a cupcake plant.
I get it.
And then that song, Tyson will be leading that one, so on the keys, Tyson's leading that one for all you camera people. We'll go straight to him. Then we'll go into CP spot. The band will continue to play behind Ryan.
Hey!
Hey guys, so something came up while I was editing that I wanted to talk about this week. We had a issue at our 10 o'clock service where basically the wrong song got queued and the tempo was way slower. It was not really Jaden's fault. Jaden's a drummer. Normally we were gonna play four songs, the fourth song being The Blessing. But since we pre-recorded that on Wednesday and then we're basically playing the video of it instead of us playing it live, what happened was we played the first set at 8:45, played our three songs, and then when we went to start over at the 10 o'clock, it just moved on to the fourth song, which was The Blessing, and didn't go back to the top. So Jaden just didn't notice that, which is perfectly normal. And then he started it up and we were all kind of like, this feels slow. And Lindsay looks back and looks at Jaden. And I'll show a clip of this, you can actually see. But Lindsay looks back and gives him a look of like, what's going on? And Jaden said later that helped him realize that something was wrong a little bit quicker. And so then they have an iPad right next to the hi-hat. That he had to then change the track so that it would go to the first song and cue up the right tempo. So you can kind of see he's doing that while trying to still play a little something. And Lindsay's playing the acoustic guitar, so along with Tyson playing piano. I don't normally come in yet, so I wasn't factoring into trying to figure this out. But really heads up play. I don't know if she did this intentionally, but I thought it was quite good was that unlike the fourth beat of the count in to the next song or to the correct song, it almost seems like Lindsay was trying to ramp up her tempo of playing the acoustic guitar, and definitely on the fourth beat before the downbeat for I think the song is called Fierce, she plays the tempo of the new song rather than the slower tempo of The Blessing. And I think it helped move into that song, so it wasn't do 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 do, it wasn't so much faster. And then also Jaden did a good job of not panicking. Maybe he was panicked a little bit, but he fixed the right song, and then he did a swell in to the downbeat on the drums, so that helped rather than trying to do like some sort of beat and then all of a sudden you're playing a faster beat. Just doing a swell into the downbeat of the new tempo, I think, worked well, and Lindsey helped lead into that tempo. And then by having the swell on the cymbals and then the downbeat, everybody knows, because we're hearing it in our ears, everybody knows, okay, we're on the new tempo now, we should be good to go. And then I also put in the clip at the end of the song. We can hear our producer in our ears. So Kevin was producing this week, and he actually said something like, you know, nice recovery, shake it off kind of thing. And that was good to just have a little bit reinforcement of, okay, if you thought it was going terrible, it wasn't terrible. You know, he was saying, it's fine, just go on with the rest of the set. So just kind of what I want to talk about was, you know, at a professional level, you don't let something like that completely derail you. You just try and figure out something in the moment. And that, you know, Lindsey recognized that Jaden's the only one that can change the tempo. So she looks at him, you know, she doesn't look at me to try and figure out if something's wrong. She looks at the person who can actually do something about it. And, you know, and he immediately realizes too, because it was considerably slower. I don't know by how many BPM, but noticeably slower. And, you know, and there's multi-tracks in there too. So there, if there was going to be like pads or something, they potentially could have been in the wrong key. It could have been bad. So luckily I don't think there's much at the beginning of the blessing other than the count off. I think normally there's like piano or something. So we got away with one there a little bit, but just if you have something like that happen, try not to let it derail you, and you know, focus on who can actually fix it. And usually it's, if it's a tempo thing, it's probably going to be the drummer. If it's a key thing, you know, whoever's starting the song, if it's piano or guitar, if one of them are wrong, they probably just need to drop out. Maybe the guitarist has to fix their capo, or I've been around it where the keyboard's playing and they use like the transpose feature. Say they like learn the song in C, but we're playing it in B flat. And they did that on the previous song, and then now they're back in a regular key and they forgot to like re-transpose it back, so it's up a whole step and it shouldn't be, or something like that. So basically those people just have to kind of like gracefully drop out, fix the thing, and come back in when it feels natural. Don't necessarily, that's the other big thing too, is don't necessarily jump back in when you're ready. Jump back in when it makes sense for your part to come in. So I've had it where when I've been playing bass or like electric or something, I've had something like that happen. And then say, so we get done with the intro and then the verse is happening. It might sound weird to come in like on the third bar of the verse, you know, so wait till like the end of a phrase or wait till the end of a section to come back in so it actually sounds normal in a progression of the song. Don't just come in on beat three of the third bar, you know, with your part, because then the audience will actually notice that it sounds weird, like, oh, that came out of nowhere. So if you screw up, just think about when to come back in too. So you can see the clip here. I'll show that next, but I just wanted to kind of talk about that being something that I think, you know, at the professional level, people have had it happen to them enough times because they've played a lot, and so they don't freak out, and the rest of the band members too. Like, so I wasn't playing, but, you know, I kind of looked at the drummer, but I look at the drummer normally when I'm playing, so that wasn't out of place. But it's not like I was going, dude, like, what the heck? You know, I wasn't doing anything like that because there's cameras on us. So don't give away that someone screwed up if nobody, you know, if, say, the drummer screws up and nobody really notices, but I look at the drummer like, what the heck? Then people are going to see that and then go, oh, what did the drummer do wrong? Like, so don't give them away just because you're, you know, you're making some sort of facial expression or body gesture thing. So professionals will kind of roll with the punches. So that's kind of what I wanted to just talk about this week in the vlog, and So check out the video, and then I'll show the rest of the service, and you guys can watch that.
Now and listen to a great message.
One.
And we'll see you guys here back later.
Two. Intro. Two. Three. Four. Intro, two, three, four.
Good recovery, guys. Good recovery.
Intro. Two, three, four.
While I was getting an epidural. Me getting the epidural. So we are tougher than you. I'm sorry to say. You need us. You couldn't live without us.
Wow. That is so accurate. Adam's like back in somewhere in this building like, oh no.
Yeah.
Everyone knows I'm such
I'm sorry. It's just the truth.
I love that. That's so good. Like, sometimes I think all you have to do is ask, like, would you rather give birth or, like, X? And they're like, obviously X.
Exactly.
Like,
so we're tougher than you. I'm sorry.
It's so true.
Yeah.
Wow. You can't top that, I don't think. But we want to hear your comments, guys.
Yes.
We also have a really fun treat for all the moms today. You guys need to get in your cars and go to your Embrace campus because we have a drive-through experience for you. Mom's Day drive-through where you're going to get a cupcake, an iced coffee, and an activity to get your husbands, your kids, whatever, out of the house today.
Yes.
She's
Thank
got
God.
A big opinion on that.
Yeah.
You
do.
Need a day to yourself. Or if you know you need to be with the fam, go with them. But it's like the scavenger hunt. It's really cool.
Yeah.
It's going to be really fun for you guys. So come to your campuses right after service, anytime before 12:30, and check it out, okay? It's going to be awesome.
Yes.
With that, let's kick it into worship, should we?
Sounds great.
One.
Message, let's do it.
Two. Intro. Two. Three. Four.
Thank you.
Intro, 2, 3, 4. Intro, 2, 3, 4.
Two, three, four.
I know I will never be alone.
Verse 2, 3, 4. she tells me she loves me.
Guys,
because she buys us things.
She helps me when I need help.
Because, yeah.